Welcome back to another slow fashion video. I hope you're all doing well. Today I wanted to dive back into the topic of how powerful our clothes that are already in our closet can be when we want to change a look without shopping. So today I'm going to take four very basic outfit formulas and I'm going to style them from looking a little bit more bohemian, maybe a bit maximalist, which is going to be a challenge because that is not my style personality at all. And then I'm going to style them to look more classic and timeless, maybe a bit more minimalist. So if you like the idea of shopping your closet and reducing your consumption but still looking and feeling really good, hit subscribe right over here. And you can also follow me on Instagram. I'll leave that somewhere here, and let's jump on in. So before actually going into my closet to create some of these looks, I like to take a moment and pull out the major themes or style elements of bohemian chic and classic chic. Am I just calling everything chic at the end? Anyway, apologies. I like to do this because it really helps me understand a look and style vibe without focusing so much on garments that I probably don't have. And I get a little bit deeper into how to identify elements of style and what they mean and how you can use them in my live Shop Your Closet events. The next one is happening on May 29th, Saturday at 1 p.m. EST, except it's a little different because I don't shop my own closet. I shop the closets of two wonderful women who have very different style personalities and different figures as well. So you can really get an understanding of how these styling elements apply and how to shop your own closet, reduce your consumption, and still put some killer looks together. So I'll leave all that information in the description box below. When it comes to this bohemian style, some of the key themes that I pull out of it were definitely an abundance of prints. There's a lot of this artisanal or artistic sense and essence to these looks. Another theme are things like really embellished accents, fringe and tassels, all those little extra details playing up volume and adding a little bit of drama and interest through movement. I've already mentioned it, I think, in a couple of these themes, but texture is huge. And if you want to go even deeper, I think the textures that really resonate with this bohemian style are the textures that come across as being very organic and natural. Layers also play a pretty big part in a bohemian outfit, and they don't necessarily have to be heavy. This could apply to, you know, layering a whole bunch of rings on your hands or bracelets, necklaces. This bohemian style really is almost like a mishmash of different styles and references, and that goes with color as well. And I think the use of color, whether it's, you know, building a more monochromatic look or using multiple different colors, I think it's just very liberal. It's like, you do you, which is awesome. I am starting to think that bohemian style people have more fun, but I don't think that's true. I like to think that I'm a bit of fun and I'm a classic dresser. Oh God, anyway, let's move on. I think I would be remiss if I did not mention a 70s influence. And the last theme that I noticed, I found that there were less stark contrasts. It seems to be that, you know, the colors and textures and everything kind of melds into each other. There isn't really like a striking sharp contrast that the eye can grab onto. So now that I've taken a look at those elements of bohemian style, it's time to look at the elements of a more classic and refined style. And I'm so curious to know sort of which style archetype or personality applies to you or you feel you resonate more with. Let me know in the comments below. The first thing that I think is so prevalent is this sense of structure in the silhouette. So whether it's a structured bag or perhaps a blazer or a crisp collar, when it comes to color, I think there are a lot of neutrals and very classic prints, and they're often used in a way that makes more of a visual impact. fact. I also think there are a lot more sharp contrasts to the eye, whether it's that structured silhouette or whether it's contrasting neutrals or even neutrals with a pop of color. In terms of proportion and volume with classic style, it's a lot more harmonious and less dramatic. So proportions are very balanced. Tailoring is another theme that plays really well with classic style. Tailoring and well-fitted garments doesn't necessarily mean things like waist definition or elongating your legs. It just means that garments look as though they were almost made for you. So it depends on the person and what their body shape is and what are the assets that they want to show off, and garments are tailored to their specific shape. So that's what I mean when I talk about tailoring and shape. There's more adjustments to the clothing in a classic look because it's comprised mostly of basics. Tucking shirts in, cuffing pant legs, or cuffs on shirts. So now I'm ready to jump into my closet and put these looks together. Let me know again which style personality is like the one you lean more towards. Don't forget to buy your ticket to the live Shop Your Closet studio. I would love to see you there. Everything is in the description box below. Have a wonderful rest of your week, rest of your day, and I will see you in the next slow fashion video. Thank you so much for watching. Ciao!